Welcome to ADTV, and today you catch up with us on the incredibly scenic Wroxham Broad, and there is a really good reason why we're here today, and that is because the Broads themselves, the Broads and the river systems, are a huge holiday attraction for literally thousands and thousands of people every year come to visit these waters. And when you look into it, you can really see why most of those people coming down have a go at fishing. So if you are coming down, you're not local, or you just want to know a little bit more about the Broads, hopefully this short little piece will give you an insight of exactly what you can expect. Now, first of all, the Broads themselves, there's absolutely loads of them connected with a series of river systems as well. So there's a serious amount of water that you can fish. But whether you find yourself on a Broad or a river, the fish that you're targeting is quite important. So for this time of year, I would say that sort of perch, roach, skimmers and bream are your main sort of target species. Obviously there's a whole host of other freshwater species in here, but they can be quite tricky. So unless you're specialistly targeting those, stick with the ones we just mentioned. In the winter, everyone knows the Broads is a massive pike scene and perch scene, but perhaps that's a video for us to go over when the weather cools down. But for now, we've chosen to bank fish and to feed a fish. So it's one thing for me that I think anyone coming down can do. It's incredibly simple, but such an effective way of fishing. So getting in a little bit to the session and how we do it, like I said, chosen to feed a fish. And the reason for that is because we can get a swim going, you know, we can get a lot of bait going in, get the fish come into us and get some competition going. So what I'll be doing is regularly casting out my feeder against the clip. So I'm casting at the same distance and I've picked the far bank marker as well. So throughout the day, I'm gonna be building up a swim and hopefully the fishing will get better and better as it goes on. Now the rig itself is incredibly simple. So feeder fishing doesn't take much of that. You could easily just do like a running feeder just on the line, a real simple basic running rig. It really wouldn't make a difference. But for me, I use one rig, whether I'm in the river or here on the still waters of the Broads. So my rig, size 14 hook, 2 foot hook link, that then runs onto a double barrel swivel. All that swivel does is stop my hook link spinning up, and then a two loop system which my feeder runs on. And all the two loop does, it gives a little bit of freedom before the fish feel that bolt rig effect against the knot, and then hopefully you're into the fish. And then in that loop, my feeder just runs on a quick change swivel. So if I need to change the weight I want to cast further, or if I was in a river and a tide picked up, I can change the weight of that. Very, very simple. So you really don't need to be at any sort of level to fish on here. Feeder fishing, you should catch a few fish. And hopefully today we're going to do that. But before we do that, we'll talk to you the baits that we've got today. So for me, we're filming today. I've seen the Broad, it's incredibly clear. I think it's going to be relatively tough. So I've gone for me the best bait that I believe you could use for the session. And that would be perhaps a couple of kilo of really good quality ground bait. Mix a couple of those together. And then in there, I've got some fresh casters, fresh maggots, and some worms as well. Plus a tin of sweet corn. So if you put all that together, it can be relatively expensive, I'm not going to lie. There's cheaper ways of fishing, but for me that gives you the best possible way of catching fish here. So if you really wanted to have a day's fishing, that's what I would use. If on the flip side of that, you're just here for on holiday and you want to, I don't know, have an hour's, 2 hours fishing, you could use some breadcrumbs and some corn. And don't get me wrong, you're going to catch fish as well, but perhaps not to the level you would if you really got some fresh bait and went for it and attacked it properly. So then all it leaves us to do is talk through hook baits and how we're filling the feeder. So hook bait wise, I'll be fishing maggots and perhaps a few worm sections today. Hopefully we're going to be having roach, skimmers. If we're lucky, we might catch some bream, but it is quite clear as I mentioned. So that could be a tough one. We'll see how we get on. So yeah, they're the hook baits. And then filling the feeder, all I'll do with that is I'd put basically a sandwich effect. So I'll plug one end with ground bait. Inside there I'd put worms and casters, and then plug the other end to make a lovely little sort of sandwich. And that's what I mean about getting bait in there. Hopefully those fish are going to come in and we'll be catching them. So that's a very, very quick tour of how I would fish the Broads if you were coming down. Hopefully now I can get into the session and put all that into practice. I'm going to get some casts out, enjoy the scenery, and hopefully, fingers crossed, the fishing kicks off as well. So let's get on with that now. Well, there we have it, a typical size skimmer. We've had loads of these today, plus a few of the others, a few perch and roach. It's been a real busy day's fishing, and you can see why. Literally, like we said, thousands of people are coming to the Broads every year. So I hope if you're coming down here and a little bit of information with you today, get you on the way to some more success on the Broad system. But we'll get him back and we'll get the other slip back as well.